Hello, welcome. My name is San. This is a reading today for Cancer. There are no dates on my readings. I trust that when they find you, if they resonate, then they're yours at that time. Cancer, I'm doing your reading today with the Tarot of Mystical Moments blended with the Oracle of Mystical Moments in one stack. So you will see a mix of both in your spread today. You've got the Fool on the split. And under my umbrella on the bottom of the deck. So somebody else had the Fool on the split, I think recently, talking about, am I taking the right path on the beginning of stepping out in some way? It's funny because this under my umbrella, it's like you're really inconspicuous. You're trying to kind of fly under the radar with something. You're doing something new. You're already self-conscious about that, about attempting to make a new choice, explore a new avenue of some sort, but you're also extremely self-conscious about it. Like, it's going to draw a lot of attention, so you're trying to kind of fly under the radar, but I don't think you're doing a very good job. At least you're feeling that way, like you're drawing a lot of attention. So, you know, it's almost like, make a run for it when the weather isn't very good. Maybe other people won't be out as much because it's raining out. It's raining out. It's a good time to make a run for it. So Cancer's trying to do something without getting noticed. Okay, I'm going to pull you a Dream Decoder card as an overall energy. So I let somebody else record in my space the other day. It's really interesting. Nobody ever comes in here, really. I mean, my daughter comes in every once in a while, but... So somebody else was sitting here in this chair recording the other day, and this is my first time back since then, and I had to like adjust everything. It's like if you ever had anybody drive your car, and then when you get back in it, you have to like put everything back, get the seat in the right position, get the mirrors in the right position again. It's a very strange feeling. So anyway, Dream Decoder card for Cancer. So, I mean, that could be relating to you, actually, Cancer. It's like you're back in the saddle again after a little while. You're having to make all the adjustments to get back to your comfort level. So that's the interesting thing. I want to say that you're doing something new, but maybe it's not that new. Maybe you're just kind of getting back to something that you've taken a break from, perhaps, for some of you. So, Dream Decoder for Cancer. Beach. Okay, there you go. You've taken a break. Cancer's been on a vacation. Let's see. Longing to escape. What's jumping out at me is the phrase longing to escape. What's funny is I feel like maybe you've been on a little bit of a retreat. You're coming out of that. It's like time to get back to work, but you're wanting to escape. You're going back to work maybe, but you don't really want to, is the feeling that I'm getting. You don't want to leave your seclusion or your safe place. So that's your overall energy, wanting to stay there. Okay, so we're beginning your reading, Cancer, with the Ten of Swords, which I want to say is feeling really under pressure, feeling a lot of being dissected by other people. It's clearly a very uncomfortable situation for you. So there's something going on with you, Cancer, that is drawing a lot of attention. I mean, like I said, maybe you're just back from being away for a while. So everybody's kind of, you know, that after you've been, you remember being in school and having like summer vacation and coming back in the fall and everybody's kind of checking each other out because we've all been through so much growth and change over the couple of months we've been away that everybody's just really interested in what the differences. It's like, so that's interesting. And it comes with this Page of Wands next, right? It's like, you feel like you're being examined, picked apart. I feel like you've been away for a while, Cancer. You're suddenly back in view, or you're just back from somewhere. And it's that. It's so I want to say, actually, that it's not, there's no, I mean, maybe there's some critique or some resistance from the others, but I actually want to say it's almost like a really friendly, like, Cancer, what have you been up to? noticing that you've changed and wanting to understand that. You see what I mean? Like I was describing about coming back after summer vacation. It's actually like a curiosity and an interest, an investment in you, but it's making you uncomfortable. I mean, you are Cancer, right? So it could just be that you don't like that much attention on you. So you're coming up as the Sea Witch next, right? So this card talks to me about strangeness. It's like, and I'm not saying that you're strange, Cancer, but what I'm saying is that all of this attention on you is making you incredibly self-conscious. Like I was saying here, it's like there's no hiding. There's no hiding. And the more the attention is pointed at you, the more it makes you feel like you're an oddball. You're clearly not an outcast. I want to say that they're interested in you. So you're not, it's not that you're an outsider or unusual or strange, but it's making you uncomfortable. Absolutely. Right? I'm just trying to see if there's any more information in this Sea Witch card. It's everything about, it's like you, like I said, the more they look at you, the more self-conscious you are. It's like it starts with one thing, like, it's starting with just like, is my appearance okay? Am I having a bad hair day? And then to every, like, because it's spreading to accessories and everything. It's just spread. It's almost like you're becoming completely self-critical the more that the attention is on you. And then the Moon and the Page of Cups next. I want to say that it's like you can only take it so long and then you retreat again back into your safe place, back to your home, back to your lair. I mean, the Moon energy is a Cancerian energy, right? So it's just, it's looking like, it looks to me, Cancer, like you're making a big, brave new move. You kind of get a couple steps down that path and then you have to retreat because it's like, it's too much. It could just be that you've been alone for a long enough time that you're, it's a acclimatization process. You're just not used to this much attention and dialogue. And then the butterfly garden next, right? Okay, so there's all this kind of energy of making a big move, a big splash, being really noticed, but then having to retreat, being back in your quiet space, back in your home, being really quiet and in your own energy. But it's interesting because it does include this butterfly garden card here, which is talking to me about like transformation, change, transformation is calling you. So you go back into your quiet space, and when you're there, once you've kind of gotten the jitters out of your system, your focus is on some sort of a transformation. There is a transformation calling you. There's something calling you out there. This is kind of looking like this dangling, like a carrot is out in front of you. You want to go, but you don't want anybody's attention. Like I said, it's like you want to make a run for it in the middle of the night. So you have somewhere you want to go, but it's almost like you have to go through a crowd to get there. How do I do that without being noticed? Seems to be your question. Because you got the Wheel of Fortune. That's what I mean. There's some, it's like the Wheel of Fortune and this butterfly garden are talking about that, like it's time to make a move. It's time to turn this wheel. She's holding a clock, right? And the Heart. So something is calling you, I want to say, something near and dear to you. But this card is also talking to me about completely feeling exposed, like anybody's attention on you is just feeling like X-ray vision with the Three of Wands. It's like just wanting to turn your back. It's this real back and forth. It's like, I need to make a run for it. I need to go. I need to get over there, but I can't. It's too hard. It's too hard. And so it's like two steps forward, one step back, or one step forward and two steps back. Like, I feel like this is really a challenging situation for you, Cancer. The Three of Wands talks about kind of being ready to move in a new direction, starting a new chapter, right? It's like looking out onto the horizon and the world is calling you out there. But then the Red Garden coming next. Interesting, because this card came up the other day and I was talking about it, like I always see it as envious. So that's interesting. So you step out of your shell, or you just step back out into the world, after being quiet for a while, and immediately heads are turning and looking at you. And that clearly that's what's making you uncomfortable. But what I want to say about this card, there's kind of a, I want to say there's a little bit of a misunderstanding on your part, Cancer, just because you don't like the attention, is that you're taking, you just don't like the feeling of it, the way it feels in your body. And that's all that you need to know. I don't like this feeling. I want out of it. But I want to say that the intentions of the others are, they're interested in you. The fact that it would come up as envy is like, they're looking at you like you're attractive. You're compelling to them, right? You're not strange and unusual and undesirable. They're looking at you so closely. It's like they're examining you. They're dissecting you is how it's feeling to you with this magnifying glass and all of this. And so you think it's like they're looking for something to critique, or they're, you know what I mean? Like there's something wrong, but it's actually not that at all. It's this feeling of curiosity and interest. I want to actually say investment. They're invested in you. It's like they haven't seen you in a while and they're happy to see you again. So the Red Garden is actually almost like a celebration card, but you're seeing it as maybe it's just an uncomfortable. I was going to say anger, but it's not quite that. But it's something along those lines. Anger being irritation. Like there's an irritation about you being back in the midst. Something like that. What's Cancer doing here? But that's not it at all. And then the Sea Witch, it's bringing up my brother, who's a Cancer, actually, interestingly enough. And I'm thinking about often when my brother, who's a couple years younger than me, but he's clearly a grown up now. Often when I dream about him, I dream of him as a child. There's something about that. It's like there's something about this situation, Cancer, that I want to say is like, it's stuck in your childhood. Something happened in your childhood that made you feel like you were in the spotlight in a really uncomfortable situation. It's making me think back to when I was in kindergarten and I was on stage for one of the first times ever. And one of the sets was coming in, and it hit me on the head in front of the whole school. And I've had stage fright ever since then because of that, because I thought the whole school saw me get bumped in the head and I was so embarrassed. But I mean, looking back at it now as a grown up, I know that probably nobody noticed it except for me. I mean, nobody came over to see if I was okay even, right? Like this big thing cracked me in the head as a 5 or 6 year old, and nobody reacted to it. So I don't think anybody saw it, but to me, I was horrified, and it embedded in my cells. So I was so excited to be on stage that time. I remember being excited to be there and looking out at the crowd and seeing faces that I knew. And then that happened. And from that moment on, I have avoided the stage. I've always hated public speaking. And I'm sure that it's about that. It's something like that. It's like you're being triggered in a way that goes back to something like that in your childhood where you felt ashamed or embarrassed. And it's like you're still carrying it with you. That's kind of what this fish here is talking about. It's like you're still carrying this awkward moment with you. So again, I see it's almost like you're getting these false starts. You're kind of like taking a few steps out and then it's too much. And so you're backing up and hiding again, because I'm seeing you, it's kind of like you retreat back into your quiet space. You go back into your garden in a sense. There's all this beautiful imagery of gardening and such. So it's like you go back into your safe space, but it's like you're taking it with you. It's becoming this real burden for you. And then look at this, like a bird, right? And it's like actually Cancer, it looks like Cancer's actually considering not doing it. It's like you're right on the fence. Every time you try and then have to step back, it's adding this weight to you where you're starting to feel like you can't do it. You're not going to be able to do it. And then this King of Pentacles card coming up next. There's a lot in this card. I always talk about it as counterpart. Today, it's talking to me more about, just representing the world. The King of Pentacles just kind of, to me, talks about the earth, right? It's symbolic of the earth. So this is kind of what I was saying at the beginning here. It's like, here's you, Cancer, kind of in your safe place, looking out with the star at the end here, looking out at this desired place that you want to get to, but it's like you have to go through the real world in order to get there. And that's the part that is so tricky to you because you're feeling so on display, which is interesting because this card talks to me about the pentacles and the antlers there. Talk to me about gifts being on display. So, and that's what this is talking about. It's like, Cancer, you have some sort of beautiful gift that is desired by people. You might feel really strange about it because it may be really unique. You may not be like the others at all, but you're not seen as strange because of that. You're seen as desirable because of that. You see what I'm saying? So it's almost like you're trying to figure out how to get through without being noticed, like I said, or without being touched by them, without being impacted or affected because you're so sensitive. And it's like it's calling you so much. I can see it here. I mean, you've got this transformation and the star at the end. That's at the end of the row for you. But there's just, it's almost like, it's interesting that I would say this. It's almost like having to go to the dentist, it's feeling like having to get teeth pulled. Like it's so uncomfortable to you, but the place that you're trying to get to is like your dream. So it's almost like Cancer is considering not pursuing their dream because there's some uncomfortableness in the middle that's like getting teeth pulled, that you're sitting here saying like, I don't think it's worth it. I don't know if it's worth it. Maybe I'm just gonna skip it. So I don't know, and it's interesting with all these needles here. It's like there seems to actually be a physical discomfort. I mean, just being the center of attention could feel that physically uncomfortable to you. Like I was saying with me, like stage fright. It's so physically uncomfortable for me that I'll avoid it at all costs. Right? So it's like that. You're having to face something that is so physically uncomfortable to you that you want to avoid it at all costs. But it's almost like, but suddenly or lately, or maybe even for a long time, this dream has been calling you. And it's like you know you have to go for it, Cancer. So what's the fastest, easiest route to get you from where you are to where it is with the least discomfort? That seems to be the question. I want to say that part of it, before I pull cards and move into the extended, see what else we can pull out of it. But what I can see here is perhaps this awareness, like I was saying, that it's a thing that goes back to your childhood, which perhaps if you try to work through that, if you witness that again, I've been talking a lot about doing hypnosis work and looking back at the original injury point and just witnessing it again can often heal it or overcome it. But also there's this soothing that wants to happen for you, Cancer, about that the attention that you're receiving is really, it's an admiration because what you are different. I want to say that. Like you do stand out, absolutely. You're really uncomfortable about it. Like you're awkward. You think you're awkward, like baby Huey like, right? Like just uncomfortable, awkward, clumsy. But that's not how they're seeing you at all. When the others are looking at you, it's like their heart swells up. There's love. All this pink and red energy is just, they adore you. And I also want to say that you might feel like they can see right through you, like an X-ray vision, but they can't. That's not what's happening. I know it feels that way to you. It feels that way to you, but it's not really what's happening. So there's maybe what could assist you here, Cancer, is trying to understand that. Maybe at a distance, when you're in your quiet space, re-examine the interactions. It's like really hear what's being said to you. If people are coming at you with a lot of questions, is it accusatory or is it curiosity, right? It's like be discerning, feel into their vibration, but I know you got to do it from a distance. It's like this hypnosis thing where you have to pull yourself out. It can't be in first person. You can't be in the middle of the interaction. It's like that highly sensitive I've been talking about highly sensitive people. It's like it's like you're a raw nerve. You get overwhelmed. You have to be outside of the situation and almost view it from an outsider's perspective, because I think the intention, getting to the good intentions of the others who are surrounding you, may help ease this for you a little bit. I'm not saying that you're going to get through it without any discomfort. I honestly feel like you're going to have to just rip the bandage off and go for it, Cancer. That's what it's almost like, hold your breath, go as fast as you can, and get to where you're going as fast as you can. But these might be some techniques that can help ease it a little bit for you. But I am going to pull cards and create an extended and see what else the cards want to say for guidance for you. If you're interested in that, the link is in the description. And if not, I will see you next time. Thanks. Bye.